各位弟兄们平安。
Church Shalom。
早上好。
Good morning。
感谢主，我们今天能够来到跟大家一起来见面。
That we get to see all of you here today。
其实我在新生命教会信主呢，1990年的时候，现在是33年了。
The moment I accepted Christ was in the year 1990, and it's been 33 years since.
Patrick 牧师呢，就是那个时候就是带领我的。
Pastor Patrick was the one who led me to Christ.
所以我很开心来到这里，我看到很多的老朋友啊。
So I'm extremely honored to be here, and I'm very happy to see some old friends and old faces.
Pastor Patrick 那时候就是带领着我的，所以呢，那个成长呢是他陪着我的 ，OK。
So Pastor Patrick was the one who led me and led me to my growth.
所以后来我去到Phu Chong啊，这里我也要谢谢 Pastor Raymond 在这里啊。
And after that, I went to Phu Chong, and here, of course, many thanks to Pastor Raymond.
Pastor Raymond 那个时候他在Phu Chong英文堂了已经。
Pastor Raymond was serving in Phu Chong English Church then.
他每次见到我说，哎。福中那边有很多华人啊，很多华人啊。
And every time he sees Pastor Gideon, he says there's a lot of there are a lot of Chinese in Phu Chong.
哇，很大的合场啊。
It's a huge marketplace.
所以呢，哇，听到这样子，哎，我也回去祷告 ，OK。
And after that, I went home to pray.
哦，是啦，这个声音好像这个马其顿的声音。
It's like the voice of
Macedonia. Okay, 所以今天能够很荣幸跟大家一起见面。
And I'm very happy and honored to be here today.
我在这个新生命教会，其实我非常爱这个教会。
I love this church, New Life Restoration.
因为新生命教会的确从我第一天信主到今天，他一直都栽培着我。
And this was where I was reborn, and this is the place that nurtured and helped me.
哇，谢谢很多我的长辈在你啊。
So thank you to all the elders here.
也谢谢你们，还有谢谢我们这位 Pastor Kenneth 牧师啊。
Thank you to Pastor Kenneth and
他是很棒的一位牧师，他们两夫妇。
He's a great pastor, the both of them.
Hello, Anne 哦，感谢主。好，我们就进入今天的主题。
Praise the Lord. Let us receive.The message of today.
今天的主题呢，我们是讲到就是一起来重建属灵的城墙。
And the title of today's message is about rebuilding the spiritual walls.
经文呢是在尼希米记的一章了1-11节。
And the scripture is found in the book of Nehemiah, chapter 1, verse 1-11.
所以比较长，所以只是用英文来读好吗？Samantha 跟我读啊。
So it's pretty long, so let us just recite together. The words of Nehemiah, son of Hakaliah.In the month of Kislev, in the 20th year, while I was in the citadel of Susa, Hanani, one of my brothers came from Judah with some other men. And I questioned them about the Jewish remnant that had survived the exile and also about Jerusalem. They said to me, those who survived the exile and are back in the province are in great trouble and in disgrace. The wall of Jerusalem is broken down and its gates have been burned with fire.When I heard these things, I sat down and wept. For some days, I mourned and fasted and prayed. Some days I mourned and fasted and prayed before the God of heaven. Then I said, Lord, the God of heaven, the great and awesome God, who keeps his covenant of and keep his commandments. Let your ear be attentive and your eyes open to hear the prayer your servant is praying before you day and night for your servants, the people of Israel. I confess the sins we Israelites, including myself and my father's family, have committed against you. We have acted very wickedly toward you. We have not obeyed the commands, decrees, and laws you gave your servant Moses. Remember the instruction you gave your servant Moses, saying, If you are unfaithful, I will scatter you among the nations. But if you return to me and obey my commands, then even if your exiled people are at the farthest horizon, I will gather them from there and bring them to the place I have chosen as a dwelling for my name. They are your servants and your people, whom you redeemed by your great strength and your mighty hand. O Lord, let your ear be attentive to the prayer of this, your servant, and to the prayer of your servants who delight in revealing your name. Give your servant success today by granting him favor in the presence of this man. I was cupbearer to the king. Amen.
感谢神的话语啊。
Thank you, Lord, for his word.
所以我们看刚才我们所读的经文，第一节那边很清楚讲到，以西米说，我是在苏珊城的宫中。
In the scripture which we recite just now, Nehemiah clearly said, I was in the citadel of Susa.
那苏珊城呢，是波斯帝国的首都。
And Susa was the capital of the Persian Empire.
当时的世界呢，也是整个世界最大帝国的一个权力的中心。
It was also the greatest empire in the world then.
当时尼希米呢，他也是在王宫波斯的王宫里面担任这个酒政的这个的职位。
And Nehemiah was a cupbearer in the Persian palace during that time.
所以酒政的工作呢，就是先负责了要赏赐那个的酒呢，所喝的酒就是让给王喝，确定没有被人下毒的。
And the cupbearer's main responsibility is to ensure that the wine consumed by the king is untainted. That is, there is no poison.
所以很明显呢，他也是被王所信任的一个人。
And clearly, Nehemiah is trusted by the king.
而且呢，也是跟王的关系也是应该是很好的。
And he probably has a very good relationship with the king.
所以我们看到了尼希米是在最高权力的中心，他是一位的高官，可以说今天说就是飞黄腾达的丰衣足食，好吧？
And in the most powerful empire, then Nehemiah was a very important official. He was successful, he was abundant, comfortable, and wealthy.
所以他的生活呢是绝对是很舒适、很安逸的。
Yes, he led a very comfortable life.
所以在这种很安逸舒适的环境之下呢，有一天他突然听到了一位家乡的一个人给他的坏消息。
So while living his comfortable, carefree life, one day he heard bad news from his homeland.
所以就打破了他这个安逸的这个的舒适圈了。
And this news changed the trajectory of his life immediately.
所以呢，后来我们看到故事，他就带领人回去重建那个的城墙。
And as we know in the Bible, Nehemiah eventually led the people to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem.
所以我们看第一个重点呢，尼希米他关心神国的事。
The first key point here is that we see that Nehemiah is concerned about God's kingdom.
第一个重点就是他关心神国的事。你看第二节他们，那时候有我的一个弟兄哈拿尼，同着几个人从犹大来，我问他们那些被掳归回、剩下逃脱的犹太人和耶路撒冷的光景。
We saw how Nehemiah was concerned in verse 2, as it says, Hanani, one of my brothers, came from Judah with some other men, and I questioned them about the Jewish remnant that survived the exile and also about Jerusalem.
所以他说，我问他们就是关于耶路撒冷的事情。
Because Nehemiah said here, I questioned them about the Jewish, something about Jerusalem.
所以表示什么意思呢？表示尼希米他虽然现在他是身在波斯帝国，但是他的心呢想着他的同胞、他的家乡。So
what does this mean? Although he was residing in Persia, but his heart is often thinking about his homeland and his people.
他关心神的子民，他关心神国的事。
He is concerned about God's people and he's concerned about the matters of kingdom of God.
因为这一群的人，他们回去耶路撒冷，这一群的人，他们是一群很爱神的人。
Because these people who returned to Jerusalem were godly people who loved God.
因为他们也曾经被掳的，现在他们回去耶路撒冷，是他们再回到那边，是重建圣殿，重建他们的信仰，重建他们的家园。
Because they were once exiled, they were once captured, and now they are returning to Jerusalem to rebuild their home.
这一群的人，他们已经回去耶路撒冷，曾经有两批的人回去了耶路撒冷。
So there have already been two batches of Jewish who returned to Jerusalem.
第一批的人呢，大概有50,000的那个领袖叫做所罗巴伯带领他们回去的。
And the first batch, there were about 50,000 people, and it was led by their leader Zerubbabel.
所以这一 第一批的人呢，他们回去的时间跟尼希米的时间相隔已经是94年了。
So between these two batches, these people who have returned to Jerusalem, it has been 94 years since.
所以由此可见呢，尼希米呢，他是在波斯这个地方出生的这个一代来的。
And from this fact itself, we know that Nehemiah was born in Persia.
所以呢。从我们这样子 来看到，就是尼希米他在波斯那个地区，他在那个出生的话呢，他不一定有这种的感受，第一代那被掳的那种的同感深受的。
So since many generations has passed, we know that Nehemiah, who was born under the reign of Persia, may not resonate with the feelings and the experience of the first batches of exile.
他也没有那种第一代的人那种的经历的。
He did not experience what the first batch of the Israelites experienced.
所以他已经在波斯帝国呢，他也有事业的这种的成功。
And he has already built himself a very successful and respectful career in Persia.
可能在生活上呢，他已经跟当地的社会呢有一种的认同感了。
And he probably has already assimilated himself with the culture and the society of Persia.
所以我们就看今天也是一样，如果我们看通常移民在海外的，他们的第一代跟第二代有很大的差别的。
So for example, looking at us, the difference between generations who migrated, first generation versus the second generation is very different.
第二代呢，没有他父辈的那一种的对故乡的那种的情怀，可能他已经融入了当地的那个的社会，甚至被同化的可能。
The second generation no longer bears the same feeling of homesickness and longingness for their homeland as compared to the first generation. They are probably completely assimilated to the new culture and society.
但是呢，我们看到了尼希米呢，在这里他是关心神国的事，他是关心神的选民。
But from here, we know that Nehemiah is very concerned about God's people and the kingdom of God.
所以，请问各位弟兄姐妹，我们关心神国的事吗？
The question to ask all of us here today is that are you concerned about the matters of God's kingdom?
今天我们关心什么呢？
What are we concerned about?
你知道尼希米他是，他跟第一批那些回去的人已经相隔了94年，再加上那些被掳的那个70年呢，总共是160多年了。
So it's been 94 years since the first generation of Jews were released back home, to the time of Nehemiah right now, and not to mention 70 earliest back when the Jews were captured. So it's close to almost 160 years.
160多年，请问有多少代了呢？
If it's a total of over 160 years, how many generations have passed?
你看35代了，对不对？
Probably 3, 4, 5 generations.
可能很多人说，哎，这些都不关我的事，是我太爷啊，我阿公阿爷的事，对不对？关我咩事啊？
Probably many people would think that this is none of my business. It's probably my great grandfather's, my grandfather's business.
现在我在这里，我已经是有成就了，对不对？
Right now I'm here. I've achieved something in life, you know.
所以从这里呢，我们就看到了尼希米呢，他为什么会关心他的那些的在耶路撒冷的选民呢
？So why would Nehemiah show any concern for the people back in Jerusalem？
原来呢，我们发现到呢，犹太人呢，他们呢对家庭的信仰是非常看重的。
For the Jews, their parents emphasize a lot on faith and religion.
所以他们是父母呢传给他们的孩子一代传一代的。
So the parents were the one who conveyed the children on religion from one generation to another.
他们的传承的信仰的传承从家庭教育开始的。
So the succession of faith comes starts from the family.
所以的父母的责任什么？他会教导呢他们的孩子教导信仰的。
Parents are responsible to teach their children about faith and religion.
当然呢，孩子呢也顺服父母的教导呢，遵循耶和华的这个的吩咐，这个才是一个蒙福的家庭，对吗
？And each child, of course, they obey the teachings of their parents and heed the orders of God. And this is what a blessed family should look like.
所以我们马来西亚现在呢，我们的家庭非常小啊，对不对
？So here in Malaysia, as Malaysians, our families are very small.
通常就是两代嘛。
We probably have two generations.
但是呢，在黎西米的时代呢，他们是一个大家庭，可能他们两三代同堂的。
Perhaps in the time of Nehemiah, they probably live with three generations together.
爸爸教导孩子，孩子呢又教导他的下一代。
You have the father teaching the son, and the son teaching.His next generation.
他们怎么样教导了？可能孩子会问，他说：“为什么我们要守耶和华的诫命
？”And perhaps the children may ask, why should we abide by the commandments of the Lord?
然后父母呢就会分享什么？分享他们的历史。
And the parents will start sharing their history.
各位弟兄姐妹，我们都有信主的历史，对不对
？Church, we have history of accepting Jesus Christ.
我们个人信主的那个的经历，那个恩典的历史，对不对
？Our experience, when we experience the grace of God, we have that experience.
所以他们会分享他们生命的经过，他们怎么样的感恩神的恩典在他们的身上。
And these parents will share how they experienced the grace of God and how grateful they were.
其实很多时候呢，我们不是你，可能你说我不会很多圣经知识，我不会怎么样教导。
And perhaps you would say that I don't really know the Bible well. I don't really know how to teach.
但是呢，我们可以分享神在我们生命里面的那个恩典，跟我们的孩子讲，这个神是信实的，是帮助我们，他会看到这个见证在父母的身上，对不对
？But the testimony of our lives, our experiences of God's grace and God's blessings are things that we can share with our children and can be shown to them.
我们来看这个的生命记呢，六章那边呢，我们这个是很熟悉的，大家。
In the book of Deuteronomy, book chapter 6, verse 4.
你看这个呢，是他们犹太人呢，他们从小呢，他们就会教导孩子的，他们每一天都要练的。
And this is something that the Jews taught their children every single day, where their children have to recite every single day.
你看他说呢，以色列啊，你要听耶和华我们的神是独一的主，你要尽心、尽心、尽力爱耶和华你的神。我今日所吩咐你们的话都要记在心上，也要殷勤教导你、教训你的儿女，不论你坐在家里、行在路上、躺下、起来，都要谈论，也要系在手上为记号，戴在额上为经文，又要写在你房屋的门框上，钉在你的城门上。
It says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord with your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be upon your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. Tie them as symbols on your hands and bind them on your foreheads. Write them on the door frames of your houses and on your gates."
这里呢是教导孩子呢要认识这位的神。
The scripture here is to teach children to get to know the Lord.
然后呢，还要爱这位的神。
And to love the Lord.
但是很重要的是由父母自己开始的。
But the key here is that this starts from parents.
从我们里面呢，就是从我们心里里面呢，对神的一个的忠诚，然后到外面，就是呢，从我的内心，然后到我的家庭。
It's an intention, a faith that drives us inside out and extended to the family.
所以你看到这个，就是我们会看到怎么样呢？就是呢，从我们的内心，然后从家庭，然后就延伸到整个的社会，就是从家里，这里讲到从家里，然后路上，然后房屋，然后城门口，就是从家庭为那个的基础。
Because as it says in the scripture where it says that I give you to be in your hearts, that means it starts from one heart and then impress them on to your children where it extends to the family. And then we write them on the door frames of our houses and on our gates, which is extended to the society.
Amen. 所以各位弟兄姐妹，今天我们关心我们的下一代吗？
Church,Are we concerned about our next generation?
我相信每个父母都很关心我们的孩子，对不对
？I believe all parents seated here care about their children very much.
但是很多时候呢，我们关心的就是我们以后孩子他们的生活怎么样，但是我们有没有很坚定的关心他们对神的那个的信心和经历和信仰呢？
But oftentimes we are very concerned about how their lives and the future are going to be, but Are we even concerned about their faith and how persistent they are in the Lord?
你看今天 我不知道你们在我的教会有时候一些父母他们呢，我看到很多基督徒的信仰只有一代罢了。
I'm not sure about all of you, but we see some members in our church where the Christian, the faith, is stops at only one generation.
只是关心自己的事。
And they are only concerned about their own personal matters.
有时候连他自己对神的信心呢，他们也守不住的。
And sometimes they would even lose their faith for the Lord themselves.
所以呢，教导孩子的他说：“哦，这个是教会的工作啊，这个是交给教会了。” OK。
When we talk about teaching, sharing the faith of the Lord, the parents leave it to church. It's the church's responsibility.
哦，关心神国的事，哎呀，这个是其他基督徒的事了，我很忙啊，对不对
？Matter of the God's kingdom is not my concern either. It's someone else's concern.
所以呢，你看，NECF 呢，我们在40天的禁食祷告里面讲到这个的天国的宴席。
As you see here, in NECF, fast and prayer, yeah. We talk about the banquet of the Lord.
他说这个是紧迫的时刻了，对不对
？We call this the urgency, of times.
那在这个的天国里面，耶稣有讲到一个比喻，对不对？那个比喻里面讲到神的国邀请很多人进到这个的大宴席里面。
In the parable, Jesus Christ, described that a lot of people were invited to the grand banquet of God.
但是有很多人呢，他们用很多很多的理由来推搪这个的主人的这个邀请。
But a lot of people refused or rejected God's invitation with various excuses.
有一些人他说哦，我要看，我要买了那块地啊，对不对
？They say, oh, I need to go check out this new property that I just bought.
然后有一个说我要去试试我买了的牛啊。
And they say, I need to go try out this cow I just bought.
有一个说我刚结了婚啊，我不能够去，很多很多的理由来拒绝啊。
Say, I just got married, I can't go. So there were plenty of excuses to reject God's invitation.
哇，我买那个地就是我们，哇，我的财富啊，我的牛就是我的事业，哦，我的结了婚，哇，是我的家庭，很多的理由拒绝，对不对
？So when the parable says that this is a new property that I need to check out, it's talking about their wealth. And when there's this new cattle that need to check out, it's about my career. And when I just got married, it's about my family. We have various excuses.
所以你看，神会祝福我们，阿门吗？
对，
神会祝福我们，阿门。
We trust that.
但是我们人心呢会怎么样？我们人心往往呢觉得神祝福了我了，我们很容易又会忘记了，觉得神你祝福我是应该是理所当然的。
But as humans, we tend to take things for granted, and we tend to forget about God upon receiving His blessings.
各位，你们有没有想过今天呢？在我们当中，神都祝福你了，或者是把你放在一个的现在的一个的地位，或者是一个的高位，或者是让你的事业有成，你的家庭很美满。
Have you ever wondered that God is blessing us today when you are placed in where you are today, what you have achieved, and what your family is like?
可能你已经有一点的财富，或者是你生活也是很安逸，对吧
？Perhaps you're a person of stature and wealth, and even living a very comfortable life as well.
但是你仍然会关心神国的事，仍然关心神的子民吗
？But despite all of that, are you still concerned about God's people? Are you still concerned about the matters of God's people?
仍然怎么样想着要去服侍这个的世界，然后来到来关心他们呢
？Are you still thinking of ways to serve the world, to serve the Lord?
所以当然我们基督徒呢，我们现在面对的社会，我们也是面对很多的挑战，对不对
？And of course, as Christians today, we face many challenges.
我们在生活上我们也很忙碌。
We are very occupied and busy.
无论在工作、在家庭、事业，有很多的账单，甚至很多的事情我们都要应付，这个是正确的。
We have a career, a family, we have bills to pay, we have a lot of problems to resolve.
有时候我们很容易被这个世界的系统呢来牵引着我们
，and sometimes we may be easily led astray by the system of the world instead.
哇，好像呢，我们没有办法，像没有留空间给我们的神，我们也很容易在安逸中，我们忘记了神在我们每个人都有这个的使命和呼召的。
Sometimes we forget that we get so busy and occupied that we leave no space for God, and sometimes we even forget that God's calling and purpose for all of us.
每一个信主的人都有使命和负责，阿门吗？
All believers and all Christians Amen. Hold a mission, hold a purpose.
所以神呼召我们呢，在这个世界上呢，神说，耶稣说，虽然我们在世上，但是我们不属于这世上。他常常提醒我们。
As Jesus often reminded us that although we live in this world, but we do not belong to this world.
他要我们要关心神国的事。
He wants us to be concerned with the matters of God's kingdom.
Amen. 我们看第二个重点呢，尼希米他听见的反应是什么样呢？
So what is Nehemiah's response after upon hearing?
你看第三节，你读吧。
In verse 3, they said to me, those who survived the exile and are back in the province are in great trouble and disgrace. The wall of Jerusalem is broken down and its gates have been burned with fire.
你看这群的人呢，他听到这个的，尼希米听到这个的消息。
So Nehemiah heard of this news.
他讲这一群的人呢，就是刚才我说是很爱神的人。
These are very godly people, people who love and revere the Lord.
他们曾经呢，很热血，很满怀的热血去回去耶路撒冷要重建那个的圣殿。
So these people once returned to Jerusalem with passion and fire to rebuild the temple of God.
他们有这种的愿意付出代价的这一群的人。
They were people who were willing to pay a price.
但是现在呢，他说他们遭遇大难，他们受凌辱了。
But as it says here, they are in great trouble and disgrace.
城门被毁坏了。
The walls have been broken down.
然后城门呢被火来焚烧，就是很荒凉了。
And the city gates were burned with fire.
哇，很无助的那种，听到会很无助。
Upon hearing this news, it feels helpless.
所以尼希米呢，他你看他在苏三城呢，其实他可以置身度外的。
Nehemiah was in Susa then, and actually Nehemiah could just exclude himself, you know, and stay ignorant.
啊，跟我无关了，对不对
？He can say it's none of my business.
但是他听到了，他说他们遭大难受临，他心里面非常的痛苦。
On the contrary, upon hearing of their difficulties and what the people experienced, Nehemiah felt pain and despair.
各位弟兄姐妹，有时候呢，我们处在这个世上，我们在每一个时代都有困难会来到的，对不对
？As we live on earth today, there are many challenges and difficulties we will experience.
所以一个大时代的困难来到了，很多时候呢，我们基督徒也看到也听到了。
When a great challenge of the generation comes upon us, some Christians may have seen it or heard it.
我们听到有一些人，他们可能会觉得很伤心，那种的怜悯的心。但是呢，有一些呢，可能哎呀，都不关我事，我什么都做不到，对不对
？Some Christians may have heard it and felt really sad and merciful about it, but some people will be like, well, there's nothing that can be done, so.
但是尼希米的反应，他是怎么样？他就祷告。这时候他能够做的，他就抓住天上的神，他从祷告开始。
But Nehemiah responded with a prayer, as the only thing he can do right now is to hold on dearly onto the onto.
Amen. 我很感谢主，我们看到了这个教会是一个祷告的教会。
I praise the Lord and I thank the Lord that this church is a church that prays.
很多弟兄姐妹呢，就是看到。这个的属灵的城墙需要被建造，所以呢，就来到祷告，阿门。
Many brothers and sisters saw the need to rebuild the walls, and that's why we don't stop praying.
阿门，感谢主。我们看到的教会呢，有很多的破口，我们有堵住，我们要祷告，只有在神面前祷告，阿门。
When we see the gaps in the spiritual walls in our church.The only thing is to pray.
所以呢，你看第四节，他们尼希米说，我听到这个话，我就坐下来哭泣，我悲哀极了。然后他在天上的神面前进食祷告了。
And in verse 4, Nehemiah said, "When I heard these things, I sat down and wept. For some days, I mourned and fasted and prayed before the God of heaven."
所以各位弟兄姐妹，除了我们教会有很多需要，我们看到很多要堵住的，还有我们看到外面是一个混乱的一个的世界，对不对
？Aside from the gaps within church that we need to pray and we need to pray after, we also see many issues in the society.
这个世界是一个混乱的世界。
The world is in the mess.
很多人呢，他们其实在外面的，他们呢是不知道要怎么样办的。
There are a lot of people who are lost in this world.
这个世界呢，已经到一个呢，就是呢，怎么样讲呢，就是非常的混乱，你知道吗？我在我的教会呢，有一个，原来有一个他要看这个心理医生，他要等，他要等最少一个月的。跟医生 make appointment.
We live in a chaotic world right now. We have a member of the church who wants to seek psychological help, but has to be in a waiting line of a month.
全部的那些医生，你要等一个多月才等可以轮到你哦。
You have to wait for up to more than a month to see a psychologist.
哇，你看这个，你看现在的已经是。不单是在外面社会，已经是冲击在教会里面了。
Not only the society experiencing this impact, churches are experiencing this impact.
成年人呢，有这个的情绪问题、心理问题，然后儿童也有，现在呢，青少年也是很多，对不对
？So emotional psychology and mental issues are not only limited to adults. It's happening to our children, to our youths.
哇，很多，我们马来西亚也是很多面对吧，对吧？
It's happening a lot in Malaysia.
我们马来西亚的挑战，上个礼拜感谢主还保持一样 ，OK， 那个选举啊。
And praise the Lord that Malaysia is still safe from the voting.
我们也很担心，哇，这个极端的这种种族啊，极端的宗教这种的挑战。
We are very concerned about extreme religion and extreme political intervention.
好像呢，这个是关系到我们的下一代，好像我们都不能够做什么，对不对？
This is regarding the next generation, but it feels like there is nothing much we can do.
但是呢，我们好像以西米一样，来跪下来祷告，阿门。
But just like Nehemiah, we need to kneel down and pray.
做我们能够做的事，阿门嘛。
Do what we can.
然后投票有没有去投票，阿门
？So go vote. Did you go vote?
阿门。你知道我在去年十一月的时候，那个全国大选啊。
Last year in the national election.
十一月的时候，我们投票了，我就跟我太太就是 Esther， 我们就那个时候是，我们就去 Mid Valley 走走。
So, in November after voting, my wife and I we went to Mid Valley.
那个时候我去到 Mid Valley 是十一点多左右。
So the time when they were, when we arrived at Mid Valley was around 11 in the morning.
你知道啊，我看到很多那种年轻的夫妇呢，他们呢没有投票，你知道吗？
I see a lot of young parents. They didn't vote.
我觉得他们是外地的，他们推着孩子，有些带着去 shopping， 拉着孩子，他们，而且那个手是干干净净的，对，干净的。
Perhaps they are not from KL, but I observe that their fingers are clean.
然后我逗留到几点呢？我逗留到大概是六点左右。
So I stayed in Mid Valley until about 6 in the evening.
你知道在两点、三点、四点，哇，很多的人潮在 Mid Valley.
So the crowd starts building up at 2 to 3 o'clock.
你知道我一直注意人家的手指。
And I just keep staring at people's fingers.
哇，这么多人没有投票的。
So many people didn't vote.
我越看越生气。
And I'm very enraged.
哇，有一些美女，穿到美女哦，漂漂亮亮。
Some very pretty girls, they were all dressed up.
哇，那个指甲弄到美美哦。
And they had their manicure done. I voted.
但是可不舍得。哎呦。
But maybe they cannot bear to see pretty nails.
哇，穿的裙子短短哦。
And they wear very short skirts.
我告诉你啊，有一天他可能穿不到裙子。
Who knows? Maybe one day they're not allowed to wear skirts anymore.
哎，我觉得不知道，我觉得华人是不是很自私的
？I feel like us Chinese can be very selfish at times.
Hello， 不是你们吧 ？OK， 跟隔壁说不是你，好吗
？The one next to you. No, it's not you. Not talking about you.
哎，我们信了主呢，我们的心有没有对着神的国度呢？阿门吗
？But as Christians, are our hearts aligned with the kingdom of God?
Amen.不是只是关心我自己的事罢了。
We're not only just concerned about our own personal matters.
我们看到教会有很多的需要。
We see a lot of needs.
我们也看到外面有很多人有需要。
And we see a lot of the needy outside.
所以呢，尼西米呢，他祷告的内容是什么？他祷告的内容呢，就是第三个重点。他祷告的内容就是他为着这些来认罪，也为自己来认罪。
So when we look at Nehemiah's prayer, we see that he repented for these issues for his people and for himself.
他为他自己的民族，为他自己的子民，就是神的子民来认罪，你知道吗
？He prayed for his tribe. He prayed for the people of Israel.
Amen.所以各位弟兄姐妹呢，真的，我们看今天呢，我们会看到呢，今天的教会呢，好像没有那种能力来见证了。
Sometimes we see that some churches of today they lack the power to testify and glorify the Lord.
没有让能力来影响这个的社会，这个的世界，好像。
They are losing the power to influence the world, change the world.
反而是世界来冲击着教会。
And instead, the world is influencing church instead.
所以我给你看一个的调查哦，这个是卡西卡森的调查。
So this study by Casey Cast.
你看他说，特别我说那个50%呢，很多五十，所以用在教会的资源精力，大部分是让会友来满意的，就是50%。
So according to the survey, most of the resources and energy of the church are used to satisfy the congregation.
20%呢是注重在只是在教会聚会罢了。
And 20% is generated to Sunday services.
但是我强调的是什么呢？是2%，只有2%去传福音，3%只有这个门徒训练，1%只是来栽培建立家庭罢了。
So only 2% is allocated to evangelism, and 3% is allocated to the work of discipleship, and only 1% to family enrichment.、
哎、这个会让你们让我们的心怎么样呢？你看这个属灵的城墙好像已经是倒塌了，对不对
？And if you can see here, these numbers show us that, like, as if the spiritual walls is already falling apart.
卡西卡森讲呢，世界上的所有的问题，那个根源是没有父亲，对不对？我们都认同。
We agree, as Cassie Caston put it, that all social issues of this world, is originated from the absence of a father.
所以呢，我们是每个做父母的，我们都要为孩子来祷告，要来到建立他们，阿门吗
？So as parents, it's very important for us to pray for our kids and to build them up.
你知道外面的社会的，他家庭都很多受到破坏。
In this outside in the society, a lot of families experience destruction.
来到我们教会，来到我教会的有很多是也是单亲的，很多是离婚，他们有一些是没有父母的，都有这些孩子都来到我们的教会。
A lot of members of the church a lot of members of our church came over from broken families, from divorced families, from parentless families.
所以呢，我们有这个负担，我们要陪伴他们，我们要建立他们。
And we have this burden to raise up these children.
所以感谢主了，我们也看到一些的成绩，他们在教会里面，他们在成长，我们就教会的这些的长辈们呢，都好像父母了，来到带领着他们，引导他们。
Praise the Lord, we are very comforted to see that some of these children actually grew very well in Christ, and a lot of the elders in the church are there to support them as their spiritual parents.
我的教会里面有几个这样子的例子，我们很感恩。
So there are a few examples in our church, and we are very grateful, and we thank the Lord for this.
妈妈很早去世，因为癌症。然后爸爸呢是吸毒的。
One of these kids, the mom passed away due to cancer in a very early age, and the father was caught with drugs.
我们就当他是自己的孩子一样。
And we took him in as if he's our own.
他说他不要读书了，到 Form 5。
And he said once he got to Form 5, he said, I don't want to study anymore.
我爸说不可以，你要读。
And he said, no, you must pursue.
感谢主，现在他大学毕业，而且他找了一份很好的工作。
And Amen. Praise the Lord, he has graduated university. Amen. And he found a great job.
还有一个孩子呢，也是一个女的，她也是家庭很贫穷。
And there's another young girl who came from a very poor family.
她现在呢，她就他我们也帮他申请到这个的奖学金，三位的奖学金。
And we applied a Sunway scholarship for her.
其实我们 有好多个我们都帮他申请到这些奖学金。
We actually managed to apply a scholarships for a number of our kids as well.
所以我讲这个姐妹现在就是一个 accountant 了哦。
Oh, and this young girl that we're talking about is an achieved accountant.
然后呢，她也现在在帮我们是一个教会的组长来一个领袖来帮我们带领其他的年轻人。
And she's also now a leader of the church, leading the youth.
所以呢，各位弟兄姐妹，其实我们要做的事是很多的，阿门。
So brothers and sisters, there are a lot of things we need to do.
阿门。神还要使用你啊。
God still wants to use you.
可能有些人当中说，哎，我的时间已经过了。
And maybe perhaps there are people who think that my time has passed.
啊，我要退休了。
It's time for me to retire.
但是今天我要告诉你，你的时间才刚刚开始，阿门。
But it's only just starting. Your time is now.
阿门。所以我们继续来看呢第四个重点吧，我们来看第四个这个第四个重点呢，我们就看到呢在祷告中会看到机会的。
And the next point here we see we will be able to see hope or opportunity in prayer.
你看你读第十一节。
And in verse 11 says, Lord, let your ear be attentive to the prayer of this your servant and to the prayer of your servants who delight in revering in your name. Give your servant success today by granting him favor in the presence of this man.
所以尼西米呢，他在祷告中他看到机会，他不只是单单祷告，他看到机会是我就是那个开始的人啊。
Nehemiah saw the opportunity in prayer. Not only he prayed, but he saw himself as a catalyst of it all.
他是神啊，我可以为你做什么？这样子的一种的祷告。
His prayer is as if asking the Lord, "What can I do for you?"
今天呢，我希望呢，我们可以为很多事情祷，但是我们很重要一件祷告，神啊，我可以为你做什么？
We can pray for many, many things, but one thing I feel we should be asking the Lord, what can I do for you, Lord?
Amen. 所以你看他说什么呢？他说，我要祷告，给我一个的机会，就是使到你的仆人现今亨通，在王面前蒙恩啊。
And Nehemiah said here, as he prayed to the Lord, give me your servant success today, an opportunity by granting the king favor in the presence.
意思说呢，他求神给他开一条的路。
And he begged the Lord to open the path up for him.
Amen.所以危机呢，其实也是一个转机来的。
So a crisis is also a turning point.
虽然我们现在看到呢很多事情呢，我们都看到好像很负面，很多面对很多的挑战。
Although there are a lot of issues occurring and we are facing a lot of challenges, things are very negative right now.
但是神让我们看到这个的机会，阿们。
But God show us this opportunity.
让我们为神呢来到。重建这个的属灵的城墙。
God wants us to take the opportunity to rebuild the spiritual walls.
从我们里面，从我们的家庭，然后到外面。
Internally, from our inside, extended to our families, and then to the society.
Amen. 所以呢，最后呢，我要总结，就是让我们一起来重建神的这个的属灵的城墙。
Now let us rebuild the spiritual walls together.
好不好？我们大家站立起来。
And let us rise.
我们也请敬拜团上来好吗
？Can we have the worship team up here？
我们要想唱那首歌，Never Fail， what's the song？ 好吗？我们要来到神面前来回应神。
Let us respond to the Lord。
我们要向神来回应说，神啊，我的时间。现在你说现在开始啊
Father Lord, this is my time. It starts now.
不是已经过去了
It's not that it has passed.
每个人来到教会他们都有需要啊
Everyone comes to church with a need.
外面也是有需要
A lot of people are in need outside of church.
好不好我们来回应神好吗
Let us respond to
God. 这个时候让我们自己来闭上我们的眼睛，我们自己来向神来回应了，自己来祷告，好吧
？With our eyes closed, let's just take this time to pray and to respond to the Lord.
主啊，我可以为你做什么
？Lord, what can I do for you?
可能你在当中，可能一些弟兄里面说，我的时间已经过了，我是要退休了。
Perhaps some members think that, my time has passed. It's time for me to retire.
你只要祷告说神啊我可以为你做什么神的灵会启示你你要做的事情
Once you ask, once you're willing, the Holy Spirit will enlighten you of the things that you could do
可能要为你的孙子为你的孩子那些还没有回到教会的为他们来祷告
Perhaps it is to pray for your children and for your grandchildren who have left the church for a while
可能神在你生命里面让你遇到一些他们有需要的一些的灵舍他们有需要的可能要你为他来传福音
Perhaps God have placed some neighbors some people around you that need you to share the gospel with them
好不好我们唱这首诗歌我们有这首诗歌来回应我们的神
Let us use the song of praise as a response
主啊，我要为着这里的每一个弟兄姐妹来到祷告。
Father Lord, we pray for each one of us today.
神啊，你要兴起这里的每一个人来到，让每个人能够重建属灵的城墙。
Revive all of us here that we may rebuild your spiritual walls.
神，让我们好像尼希米一样能够看见，主啊，这个的城墙已经是倒塌了。
Just like Nehemiah, open our eyes to see that the spiritual walls are breaking down.
像神说神啊我要怎么样做
Put this burden in us Lord what can we do
我们要从祷告开始
Lord we will start with prayer
我们要关心神国的事
We will be concerned of God's matters
神啊，我要怎么样做
？Lord, what should we do?
神啊，你把这个负担放在我们每个弟兄姐妹的心中。
Place this burden deep inside our hearts.
放在我们里面。
Put it within us.
无论我们在自己的家庭
，Whether it is in our family，
在教会
，In church，
甚至在外面
，And even outside，
都给我们有这种能力，能够去影响别人。
And、give us the power and the strength to influence others.
能够建立神你的城墙。
That we may build your spiritual wall.
谢谢赞美你，祝福这里的每一位。
Praise the Lord, bless each and every one of us here today.
奉主耶稣救生命祷告。
In Jesus Christ's victorious name we pray.
Amen. Amen. Amen.